Yeah. And then, I don't know if you want that on the board or...
Dun, 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 dun. Forging a spatula with Toby Flores.
Okay, we're gonna make a spatula. We're gonna forge a spatula. And to make the handle, we're gonna use 9 inches of half inch square bar. Step is to separate some material, so we have about a half inch material on the end that we're trying to separate, and then we're going to taper back from there. We're just using the edge of the anvil and back and forth, working two sides to separate the material on the end. That material will eventually be the end of the spatula that gets attached to the working end, and then the handle on this side. Thank you. that material on the end, and then we've tapered back with the power hammer. And then that final step with the power hammer, I kind of put the steel up on its diamond edge and knock that down, because I want this to be round. So I'm going to continue to work in this area, rounding it off, and then take it back to the power hammer and smash this end. Thank you. going to put it diamond side up and flatten this out to make the handle.
The handle is all rough forged, and I've marked the end. I've found the center both ways in each direction, and then the rivet head that's going to go in here is just under a half inch, so I just try to give myself enough room so that the rivets are not touching. And now what I need to do is just center punch these marks so that we can drill a hole for a quarter inch rivet. This is the working end of the spatula, and I've cut this out of an old appliance, stainless steel appliance, and then so I have a little template here where I traced it and then cut it out just with an angle grinder. I did kind of like bevel these three edges here so you could pick up stuff from the front and from the side, and I've marked the center here, and then I'm going to put a bend in it right about here where this other line is. So I just made this just a quick little kind of homemade break, just using a piece of channel and some clamps. You don't need much of a bend. You can just kind of do it with your hands. It may even be too much, but we'll adjust it. Yeah.
And rolling.
Ready?
Mm-hmm.
All right, the next step is that we're gonna put matching holes in the working end. So I've just marked them and center punched them. And this time, instead of the drill press, we're going to use the iron worker. The drill press would also work. Makes a nice clean hole. All right, now we're just gonna make sure that everything fits. And they fit in there really snug. There was a moment or two of just some filing to make that adjustment. Now we're ready to set those rivets. Okay. All right, before we set those rivets, we're gonna work on this end. Right now it's just cut off here, and I've found the center, and then I've marked out with my Sharpie, there's an eighth inch piece of material in the center that's gonna end up being this little hook so that you can hang it in your kitchen. All right, so we're just gonna cut these away with the hacksaw. Maybe. Now we have the material in the middle that we need. I'm just gonna file the burrs off of this and then we'll go forge that end. All right, so for this little end, we're just gonna taper this out. So it's pretty rectangular now. We're gonna tapered on that end. I'm gonna make this little baby scroll on the end of the spatula handle. Thank you. Yeah. Nut and bolt to keep one side straight while we set the first rivet, and now we're going to set the second.
Spatula?
Almost ready. Yeah. And then I don't know if you want that on the board or...
Forging a spatula with Toby Flores.